Miss Maria Buledaco, sa uban pang nag-message na. Ang atong topic karon is about take good care of God's temple. I mean, kaganinang buntag. Ang topic nito kaganinang buntag is take good care of God's temple. Atiman na ang templo sa Ginoo, sa Bisaya pa. Nara siya sa Philippians 2, chapter 2, verse 25 to 30. Philippians chapter 2, verse 25 to 30. It is all about the life of Epaphroditus. Epaphroditus. No, mailan na to ni siya karon. Okay, kung basahon. Saan ako sa Bisaya? Pwede rapod sa English. English na ako para sa benefits sa mga... English na to para sa benefits sa mga friends na to, mga igsoon na to na nasa gawas. No? Na tune in. Sige. Okay. So, sa Philippians chapter 2, verse 25 to 30. Verse 25, "But I think it is necessary to send back to you, Epaphroditus, my brother, my co-worker, and fellow soldier, who is also your messenger, whom you've sent to take care of my needs. 26, for he longs for all of you, and distress is distress because you heard he was ill. 27, indeed he was ill and almost died, but God had mercy on him, and not on him only, but also on me, to spare me sorrow upon sorrow. So 28, therefore I am all the more eager to send him, so that when you see him again, you may be glad and I may have less anxiety." Okay. So 29, "So then, welcome him in the Lord with great joy and honor people like him." So 30, verse 30 is, "Because he almost died for the work of Christ, he risked his life to make up for the help you yourselves could not give me." So, si Epaphroditus is character. Kinsa na si Epaphroditus? Si Epaphroditus is a partner of Paul, Apostle Paul, Pablo, Apostle Pablo. He's a partner of Apostle Paul, sent by the Philippians. Gihatag siya sa taga-Philippians nga mahimong katabang ni Paul sa pag-ministry sa Ebanghelyo sa Ginoo, sa pag-spread. Pero tungod kay, siguro nagkapasmo-pasmo siya, siguro nabasa siya ulan, or gikapoy na over-fatigue siya, nagsakit siya. No, nagsakit. He was ill. No, he was ill and almost died. And hapit pa gid mamatay. No? So, atong studyhan karon, why you need to take good care of your body? No, may bala na to karon. And why is it important? No? So, muna si Epaphroditus. No? Ang karakter ni Epaphroditus is, ang iyang position na, sa verse 25, no? Na siya yung upat ka karakter. Upat. No? Now, verse 25, "But I think," no? Si Epaphroditus is a brother. Ano siya? Is a brother, a soldier, a messenger, and a co-worker. No? So atong sa namakita ni muna tanan sa verse 25. "But I think it is necessary to send back you, Epaphroditus, my brother." Igsoon, no? Igsoon sa pagtuo. Igsoon diya sa pagtuo kang Kristo. Okay? Tapos ano siya? "But I think it is necessary to send back to you, Epaphroditus, my brother, my co-worker, my fellow soldier, and who is also your messenger." So, unsa to nga karakter ni Epaphroditus? Brother, co-worker, fellow soldier, and a messenger. So, kinsa may igsoon? Igsoon baka diya? Check yourself. Are you a brother in Christ? Or igsoon baka sa pagtuo? Do you believe? As long as you believe in Christ, you believe, you accepted that Jesus Christ is your personal Lord and Savior, and you believe that He died in the cross just for you, for your sin, you are belong to the family of God. You are a son of God. Igsoon ta. No? Tapos, co-worker, lumilihok ba ka sa simbahan? No, si iyo pa bro, dito's coworker siya. Lumilihok, isa siya sa mga lumilihok, no. Tanan tao la ilahi og gasa. Ang uban lumilihok sa simbahan, ang uban preacher, ang uban. So, kung ikaw isa ka sa lumilihok sa simbahan, makarelate ka ni kay isa niya siya sa mention nga character ni Epaphroditus. A fellow soldier, sundalo ka ba ni Kristo? No? Are you a soldier of God? No? And a messenger. Ga-share ba ka? Messenger ba ka? Kung, or when you receive the message, you keep it just for yourself or you share it to others? No? Kung ikaw na, pamalandungi ang life ni Epaphroditus. Okay? Okay, so, mana siya ang character ni Epaphroditus. Gisend siya sa taga-Philippians to help Paul. But nakasakit siya, kaya wala niya maatiman iyang lawas. Though, lumilihok siya para sa Ginoo, karaming paningkamot niya para sa Ginoo, pero wala, napabayaan niya iyang self. And it comes to a question niya, ang tanan ba, are all sickness or illness are a payment of your sin? Or sa Tagalog pa ba na, ang lahat ba ng sakit ay parusa? We will know here, no? Ang lahat ba ng sakit ay parusa? And ang sagot, hindi. Hindi lahat ng sakit ay parusa. Okay? Sample lang kay Hob, no? Gikuan si Hob. Gisakit si Hob pero that is not parusa. Gialaw ni Lord to test his faith, no? Inana. So, daghang kay character sa Bible nga nagkasakit sila is because of it's not dili siya parusa. Napoy mga sakit nga parusahan suka sa Ginoo. Lagi na siya. No, mabalan po na ito na diriran. So, nai, 9-7-7-7. Na ay 7 ka reasons why and how you take good care of your body. Okay? Number 1, makita na ito siya. Number 1 is, akong enumerate na lang daan tanan, then atong review. No? Number 1 is, your body is a temple of God. Number 1. Number 2, your body is a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, pleasing to God. Number 3, you have to build up your body. Build up your body. Number 4, physical training. You need to have physical training. Number 5 is, do not destroy your body. Now, number 6 is, avoid sexual immorality. Avoid sexual immorality. Okay? Number 7 is offer yourselves to God. Moni siya ang pinakalas. Offer yourselves to God. Okay, let's talk about number 1. Your body is a temple of God. Do you believe that? Do you believe that your body is a temple of God? Kung nagtuo ka ngang imuhang, if you believe that your body is a temple of God, say amen. Because it is true. It is written in the Bible that your body is a temple of God. Makita na siya sa 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19. Okay. 19. Do you not know that your bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit who is in you and whom you have received from God? You are not on your own. 20. You were bought at a price. Therefore, honor God with your bodies. So, you were bought. Gipalit na kamo at a price. So, wala ba mo na sayod sa 19 na? Wala ba mo na sayod nga ang imuhang lawas mo ay templo sa balaang espiritu? No? That's a temple of God. Holy Spirit. Na nasa imuha. Remember the story about Old Testament, you know? Old tagalan tamo graph drop na gamay nga idea. In an ancient time or in an Old Testament is you can only meet God in a tabernacle or in a temple or in a church. Panahon nilang Abraham, Moses, Joshua, tanan Daniel. That's why you have to spend one day. Dili jud ka mo work in one day because you have to spend time clean up your body and go to the temple to meet God. And in that temple, there are three parts of the tabernacle, right? Awerman mo na. And one of those part is a room. It's a curtain. It's a curtain. Now there's a curtain. Na. In that curtain, it's a boundary. That curtain is a symbol of boundary between heaven and earth, between God and man. So that's why, diba, sa Old Testament, kinamaligo ka, limpyo jud ka, and you get into that curtain to meet God, to talk to God, no? And if you are not clean enough, you will die, no? So, That is in Old Testament, no? And then, that's why the God is on, can only be found in that temple. And you have to spend one day out of 6 days, do everything, and spend one day for God alone. So, mano, you have to go there. You have to go there. But after Jesus died, in John, last chapter of John, when Jesus died, the rock was broken. The veil was torn apart. And then the Holy Spirit were able to go and dwell among us. And live in us. And live in our body. And that becomes, our body is a temple of God. And that's why you can meet God anywhere you want. Whether you sit down, you were driving, Lord, thank you, Lord. You were, protect me, Lord. You were eating, thank you, Lord, for this, for the food. Anywhere, you can talk to God anywhere already because of Jesus' death. Sa pagkamatay ni Jesus. That's why your body is a temple of God because the Spirit lives in you. Lives in you. Sometimes, mapasagdaan na to tong self, no? So, mana siya. Do you not know that your body now is the... Si Kwan ang, sa Corinthians, gisulatan ni Apostle Paul, ang taga-Corinto, to inform them that take care of your body because that is a temple of God. That's where God lives in you, walk in you, in a daily lives. In your daily lives, as long as you're alive, the Holy Spirit is in you, no? Na, mupuyo siya, no? Makapuyo siya. If you welcome, you welcome. That's why magandang gitawag na to. If you accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, di ba? Matthew 7:7, if I'm not mistaken. Matthew chapter 7 verse 7, sa panuktok, pangayo, o pangita. Si Lord na nuktok sa imong self. No? If you didn't, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I think, pagmuni-muni, I think this is the time for you to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. And say, Lord, I welcome you in my life. Walk with me from this moment on. Walk with me. And live with me. And guide me in every day of our lives. Manang atoa, diba, Christians? That's why you're called Christians. Because you believe in Christ, you accepted Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. And you believe that Christ died for you. That's why you are called Christians. Okay? So, muna siya. Ang point number one, reasons why you have to take good care of your body. Your body is a temple of God. Point number one. Number two, reason number two. Your body is a living sacrifice. Holy, pleasing, and acceptable to God. Makita na siya sa Romans 12:1. Romans 12:1, na? Holy, una, living sacrifice. Holy, pleasing, and acceptable to God. Romans 12:1. Verse 1. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. No? You mentioned yun na siya. No? Holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. That's why. How you worship God? You cannot worship God by giving money. Giving your money. Even though you give everything to the church or to God. Offer everything. That God is looking for you. You. Me. Your body. Yes, your body. Ayun pa sa Psalm, di ba? Daigas ang Ginoo. Ipakpak ang mga kamot, isayo ang mga tiil, ibayaw, ilukso. Ano, diba? So, how to use that? Can you use that by just imagination? You are using your body. That's why. Ipamulong ang gugma sa Ginoo. Your mouth is part of your body. No? So, holy, pleasing, and acceptable to God. And how can you do that if you don't take good care of your body? Like, nagmimuna kay ko. Igarilyo, inom. Niya. Grabe. Ang inom ha, don't get me wrong. Ang inom wala gibawal sa Biblia. If I'm not wrong, it's makita siya sa 1 John 5:12 nga pag inom kamo og alak, jutay ang alak. Wala jutay, pero ang Gibadlong po din ito sa Galatians dayon sa Galatians 5:22-23 kinalasan tong fruit of the spirit na ay kinalasan, ang kinalasan is di ba fruit of the spirit joy love joy peace kindness patience faithfulness gentleness last self control so adunay self control so ayo don't get me wrong wala gibawal ang inom ha pero control gi-encourage gid pud ta nga moinom ta gamay nga alcohol para ita magkasakit no basahan na siya first. Oh, sige, ako na lang yung masahon. May pop up lang siya sa akong mind karon. Para dili mo ma para dili po ko niyo, don't get me wrong kan. 1 John 5:12. Unang Juan dari yung takay para mas tali. Unang Juan 5:12. Yep, appear lang ni siya sa ko para it's part of taking care of your body. 1 John 5:12. If I'm not wrong, tama ba? Ay, dili. 1 Peter. Siguro. Drink a little. Ngitaon ko na ron. Nakakuan ko na. Nakanipop up lang siya sa akong mind. First Peter, basta nagkuan siya pero naipagpugong ha. Little wine. Kinahanglan na pugngan ato, na dili lang pud. 1 Timothy 5:23. 1 Timothy 5:23, stop. Stop drinking only water. Na ningon siya. 1 Timothy 5:23. Stop drinking only water. Drink a little bit of wine. No? And use a little bit of wine because your stomach and your frequent illnesses. Magkasakit po ta. No? Kung di po ta mo, kwan, mo inom. Pero kung sobra, anything na sobra, makadapit siya. So, that's why, point number 2 is offer your body as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. No, kinala ati manon na to ang ato ang lawas na mo present ta sa Ginoo or sa church mo ang chipan church, 'di ba? Or anything that anything nga nasa imong self, no? 'Di ba ati manon nimo? 'Di ba? If sa church po, even though gigamit na to na ang church para sa Ginoo, then after we use the church, 'di ba? Kinala na to i-arrange sa bangko, sa higa na to, pintalan, i-renovate na to, i-build up na to, pandayon. It's the same because now your body becomes now the temple of God. No, temple physically or literally temple a church, but God is staying with us right now. No, now so point number 1, your body. 1 Corinthians 6:19-20. Your body now is a temple of God. Then second point is your body is a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, pleasing and acceptable. Okay, point number 3, build up your body. Diba? Sama sa simbahan. Pandayon na to. Build up your body. Build up na to tong body. Ato po, ato apong temple ni Lord. Ato namang lawas. So, we have to build it up. Okay, so, makita siya sa 1 Corinthians 9:27. 1 Corinthians 9:27. Kinalasan. No? No. Sana? No, I strike. Kuan lang basahan, sugdon ako din sa 20 sa kuan. Sugdon ako sa 25 para maklaro gyud, no? Everyone who competes in the game goes into strict training. They do it to get a crown, no? That will not fast, but we do it to get a crown. Oh. They do it to get the crown that will not last, but we do it to get a crown that will last forever. Ambot pasabot ni Pablo ani. Ang mga magdudula, gabansay silang lawas para makakuha sila o corona or trophy. Pero kita, gabansay ta para makuha na ang trophy nga makuha sa mga boksingero. Mawala ra, mahanaw ra. Pero kita, gi-emphasize ni Pablo, Apostle Paul nga, ang trophy nga itong makuha is that will last forever, which is eternal life, which is the life in heaven. No? Mano siya. So 26, therefore I do not run like someone running aimlessly, no? wala ko ni dagan, like parehas sa uban nga ni dagan nga wa kabalo, aimlessly, aimless, wala kabalo ha padulong, wala kabalo ha paingon, or ni dagan lang siya, wala siya kabalo. Ayan direction, no? Ayan direction. I do not fight like a boxer beating in the air. Parehado ko no sa boxingero nga gasumbag ra sa hangin nga walay maigo. Nagiche target. So ang atong target is to be with God in heaven. Mamugin na. And how to do that if you don't take care of your body? So 27. So 27 is, now I strike a blow to my body and make it my slave, so that after I have preached to others, I myself will not be able, I will not be disqualified for the prize. So gibansay niya. Gibansay niya ang kaugalingon kay para madili ko ma-disqualified, no, sa gipaabot na kadaugan diya sa Ginoo. Okay? So that's why it is very important to build up your body. So we have to build up your body. So muna na point number 3. Point number 4, physical training. Physical training. Ang Ginoo mismo nag-point pod nga makaayo ang physical training, no? Di lang kay wanta exercise ana sa leg ng taas. Sige, lagad bitaw ko sa Ginoo, di ko kasagdan sa Ginoo, di ko magsakit. Ayaw. Kaya ang Ginoo mismo, ang Bible, ang word ni Lord mismo nagtudlo sa tua to take good care of your body. And how to do that? We need to have physical training, no? Physical training. Okay? And then that's why. So it can be found in 1 Timothy, in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8. So physical training. The Bible says that we really need to have a physical training. Okay? 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8. No? Timothy. First okay. 4 verse 8. Okay? Verse 8, Angel, for physical training is of some value. So there is a value. There is a value. There's the Bible, God is reminding us that training is valuable, no? Somehow it is valuable. So do not take advantage of being a servant of God and then you just don't take good care of your body. The Bible reminds us to take good care of your body. Okay? So that is point number 4. And point number 5 of taking care of God's temple. So point number 5 is do not destroy your body. So the Bible is reminding us again to not destroy our body. Okay, so 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16 to 17. 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16 to 17. Okay, 16. Don't you know that yourselves are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in your midst? If anyone destroy God's temple, God will destroy that person. For God's temple is sacred, and you together are that of temple. So, anyone who destroy, how you destroy God's temple, your body. Now, the Bible is saying that your body is a God's temple. So, how to destroy your body? Too much, anything that is too much eating, too much drinking, too much of smoking. And too much, anything that is too much, and that will destroy your body. Too much abusing your body, too much abusing. So that's why people are suffering from sickness because of too much. They have done too much, and God allows that because God says, if anyone who destroys your body or destroy God's temple, God will destroy them. That's why you will suffer because of what you have done. No? You will suffer because of what you have done. Anything that is too much, no? Galatians 5 chapter 22. Galatians chapter 5 verse 23. It says there that Self-control. Self-control. So, if you do not have self-control, that will destroy your body. Okay? Okay, point number six. Avoid sexual immorality. This is a bit sensitive, but God is telling me to share it with you so that we will be aware, no? Avoid sexual immorality. It can be found in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18. Okay. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 18. Okay. 18. It says, the Bible says, flee from sexual immorality. All other sins a person commits are outside the body. But whoever sins sexually sins against their own body. So, it's clear, right? Sexual immoralities are like youngsters. If you are not married, that part is actually holy, and it's something a gift from each other. You know? Common right now, there are a lot of early pregnancies and they suffer their lives and they were not able to finish their studies because they already have baby, they already have families, they were not ready financially, they were not. It's a miserable life, you know, right? Because they don't follow the word of the Lord. God's word says how to take good care of your body is you have to avoid sexual immorality. No, for you are not at the right age. You are not legally married. So avoid that. Try to avoid that. Okay? And another one is married people go for an affair to others. No, right? It's illegal in the law of man, and it's also illegal in the law of God. So remember, right? Whatever bind, anything that is bind in earth also bound in heaven. Anything that is loses in earth also loses in heaven. So if you don't know how to follow the law legally, then you are so ignorant, or you're so like boastful to say that, oh, I followed God's law. But you're not following the law. What is the current law in here? So it doesn't defend yourself. You know? It doesn't. No point, right? So that's why God is reminding us to avoid sexual immorality. To take care, because your body is a temple of God. If you do that kind of thing, immorality, and then you're just making a dirty mess in the temple of God, and it's so not good. Okay, all right. So but don't get me wrong, all those who committed already those kinds of things, right, you know, God is a God of forgiveness. God says like, I will forgive you 70 times 7 as long as you repent and sin no more, right? So that's how graceful, that's how merciful our God is. But don't take advantage of it, okay? Because he will be answerable. Remember, it's easy to commit sin, but it's so hard to face the consequences. It's easy to do things, to do sins. But are you ready to face the consequences? Right? For youngsters, are you ready to be an early father, an early mother, and you're supposed to get your dream, help your parents out, and build up yourself before anything? But because of that sin, immorality, then you were forced to become an early father, an early mother, not at the right age, not at the right status, financial status, and anything, right? So that is the consequences. So for anything that we do, there will be a consequences. That's why God is reminding us to take good care of God's temple by avoiding sexual immorality. Okay? And then the last point will be offer yourselves to God. Okay? So this is the last point. It can be found in Romans chapter 6 verse 13. Romans chapter 6 verse 13. Romans chapter 6 verse 13. Okay. Verse 13. Do not offer any part of yourself to sin, no? Do not offer any part of yourself to sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and offer every part of yourself to Him as an instrument of righteousness. Right? Wow! See? Do not offer yourself to a sin as an instrument of wickedness, but rather offer yourselves to God, those who have been brought up from death to life, and offer every part of yourself to Him as an instrument of righteousness. So, that's why. Offer yourself to God. How to offer yourself to God? Be an instrument of righteousness. Be an instrument. Be a model of good things. No? Do not be a model of to be a bad influence. Just God is reminding us that take good care of your body, and take good care of, yeah, your body is a temple of God. Take good care of it and use your body to be an instrument, to be a blessing to other people. Yeah, to be a blessing to other people. So, Vanessa, that's the message, okay? So, yeah, that's all. That's the morning devotion this morning, and it's just a recap. Recap now, right? So, our title, the message that God's want me to deliver to you this morning and today is take good care of God's temple, right? It can be found in Philippians chapter 2 verse 25 to 30 in the life of Epaphroditus. Epaphroditus is a brother, a co-worker, a fellow soldier, and a messenger. He was sent by the Philippians to help Paul in a mission, but he was sick, no? Nagkasakit siya. He was sick because he barely eat, and he used too much of energy, and siguro under the sun or anything, right? That's why he was sick, no? Even though he worked for Christ, but he was sick. That's why God is reminding us that you have to take good care of your body, especially those who work in Christ mission, no? And to spread the gospel, you have to take good care, because you can be sick. You're human. Magsakit jud ka. You can be falling to sick, to illness. Okay, then the seven reasons and how to take good care of your body is: number one, your body is a temple of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 19 to 20. Number two, your body is a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to the Lord. Romans chapter 12 verse 1. Number three, build up your body. 1 Corinthians 9 chapter 9 verse 27. Number 4 is physical training. 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8. Number 5 is do not destroy your body. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16 to 17. Number 6 is avoid sexual immorality. 1 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 18. Number 7 last is offer yourselves to God. Romans chapter 6 verse 13. Okay, so guys, take care of your body. Use your body as an instrument of blessing to others. An instrument of encouragement to others. As an instrument of motivating others. A motivation of others. Do not be an instrument to wickedness. To be a bad influence, right? So that you will get the crown after all. Okay? At the end of the day, we will face God. And then when God asks us, when we face God, God will ask you, son, what have you done for me when you were alive? And what do you answer? You will just say, "Oh no, Lord, I strive so hard and work so hard for myself and my family." No, that's not the will of God. The will of the Lord is to spread His word. Matthew chapter 18 to 20. He says, "Go therefore and make them my disciple. Baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." No? Go therefore and spread my gospel. Spread my word. That's what He wants. So when we face God and He knows that you have done good things for Him, you use your body, you take good care of your body to use it to glorify Him, to spread His word, He will not ask you. He will just say, He knows, God knows, God knows what you have done, every single thing, whether it's still in your mind, you haven't do it, He knows already. He will just say, "Hey, come, my faithful servant, come and join me in heaven." Okay, so thank you everyone, and I hope my little message niya nakuha and na-inspire mo sa word ni Lord. You're inspired by the word of the Lord. And once again, thank you for the private messages, message and greetings this morning. And to all who tuned in this evening, okay, just want to thank God for your lives, no? Special mention, Silingan, my neighbor, Miroy Herigdig. Thank you for tuning in, sir. Mildred Tinoy Laron, thanks for watching. Thank you for tuning in, Gao. Simpor Ako Donaire, Simpor Ako, sir. Thank you for tuning in. Lorly Almasan, Ate Lors, thank you for tuning in. I think she's in Malaybalay right now. Isadora Tertuwo, Miss Isadora from Singapore, Malaysian Singapore. Good evening, Miss Isadora, and God bless. Stay safe there. God will protect you, all of you. God's protection will cover your families. And love, more love, and God bless to all of you there. Regards to your family. Stay safe. Okay, Johnny Panaga, bro, Johnny Panaga. Thank you for tuning in. Makmos Herigdig, Silingan. Sir, thank you for tuning in. Sam Sahori, Sampitan. Si Sir Sam Sahori. Si Kuan, Kaban sa this mark before. Bro, good evening and stay safe there where you are. And God will bless you, your family. Carmi, Ma'am Carmi Balibagoso. Ma'am, thank you for tuning in and good evening. So, God bless to your family. And everyone, God bless to you. And I hope that the message of the Lord nakuha ninyo. You've got the message of the Lord that to take good care of our body. So, that's all. Comments if you have questions, and message me. Just continue to PM me those you want to clarify, and if you have some suggestions and all additions, just comment below or message me. Okay? So, thank you for tuning in and God bless everyone. See you tomorrow morning in our daily morning devotion at 4:30 to 5:30. God bless!